Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton here in San Antonio, Texas. And I gotta say, I had an amazing time at WordCamp Boston 2017. It was so cool to see all of you amazing people in the Boston area and the surrounding areas come together for an incredible weekend. Thanks so much for having me as one of your speakers. I look forward to checking it out on WordPress.tv. All right, this video is all about how to add a back to top button at the bottom of your website so that users can very quickly get back up either to the navigation or to your logo, or to your contact information, whatever might be at the top. And this is a great user experience to add, and it's a pretty lightweight plugin to include in your website. So let's get to it. I'll show you how to do that and which plugin as of today that I recommend. And it's called WP Front Scroll Top. So what I want you to always double check, no matter what time it is that you're watching this video, I want you to be sure that this plugin is still up to date, so it's been updated recently, that it's compatible with your current version of WordPress that you're running, and that it has really great reviews. And that's for any plugin. As long as that's in place, you should be okay to go ahead and install the plugin and try it out in your system. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to plugins and we're gonna say add new, and we're gonna look for that specific plugin, WP Front Scroll Top. And this is what it looks like, 40 plus active installs, which is pretty spectacular. We're gonna click install now. And of course, we're gonna activate it. So once those two things are in place, you've got an area to click on here called settings, right over here. So that's where we're gonna go next. And of course, the first step is just to enable it. I want you just to slowly work down through all of these options, but for the sake of this particular tutorial, I'm just going to show you the ones that I would pay attention to mostly. So I am going to enable this so that it works. I am going to auto hide after a few seconds so that you're not just constantly blocking it or blocking other content. You can hide on small devices, but I would highly recommend you leaving it accessible on a cell phone. I think that would be cool. You probably don't need it in the admin area, so you can go ahead and hide that. And then I also want to go ahead and add in some alt text here, so back to top, for some alt text on the image that it's going to allow me to use. If you want to use a text button instead, you can set all those options here. Your location, very typically these sit the bottom right, but if you have something there that you don't want covered up, you can apply it somewhere else. I'll leave it at the bottom right for now. You can also hide it on certain pages or posts. That's kind of cool. But for now, we're going to go ahead and leave it on all pages. And then you have some options of some default imagery that the authors give you. I'm going to choose this one. I think that's pretty cool. And click Save Changes. That simple. You can also add in your own unique button if you want. Okay, so scrolling down here, check it out. Back to top. Kind of cool, y'all. I'll see you next WordPress Wednesday. Bye, y'all.